what we're playing. Your game. I've never played a game like this, so. Okay. Cool, I guess. Hi, dog. Hello. Yes, this is a demo. Okay. Let's do it. What's your name? Really? That's your... Hey man, I'm so sorry. I am. Hey God, look ahead. Ooh. I'm gonna pick this one. Nice. I wanna go back. Sales are final. Okay. Whoa, why is there a dog? I am all of these. I guess I'm a girl. Gotcha. Alright. Ugh. I'm just playing it now. I don't know, can you? I guess not. Get out of my sight. Okay. I don't want to be a dog. Oh, great. Am I a man? What? Is he alive again? Oh. Darn. I hate it when I do that. Oh. What? Oh. What? Fairground. Perfect. It is kind of greasy. Yes. Yes. Let's go to the carnival. What am I? Oh. No. Yay. Well, there you have it. The carnival. Oh, what did I? Okay. Let's gain entry. Okay. I mean, those railings are hard a mile high. Why am I laying eggs? Might just work. This is just great. Greetings, ticket buffoon. My name's Jerry, but okay, ma'am. Why is this? Can I help you today? Jerry of ticket booth? Nah, it's fine. Simply wish to feel... Oh. Okay. You definitely need to buy a ticket from us if you want to do that. Rats! How much would that cost? $2. Pledge, I have $0. Tell me, young squire. Wait, from Skyrim? What is this? We have tales, stories, and other such whimsical parables as payment. No. No, I would not. Dang it. Oh shoot, I'm so close too. Hey, wait a minute. Aren't you that crone? Bark. Run. Look, ma'am. I'm not telling you this because you're stench. I'm not that gross. It's Valentine's Day today. Oh, no. Yeah, I'm not romantic. Oh, he's doing the... Yeah, but... Did you say that you have eggs to lay? Surely you have a mate of some kind if you're getting the baby to lay eggs. Well... This explains why they're so close to the woods. Are you telling me I'm homeless? Why is he doing the thing? It's a shame about the loner thing, though. I guess the promotion we have on for Valentine's Day would have really come in handy otherwise. Tell me more. Well, Valentine's Day is a day for people who are, you know, in love. What on earth is that? Love is, well... Thank God that music is gone. Love is what happens when two grown-ups start craving more than just business handshakes, platonic ice cream breaks. Love makes two people want to go on romantic ice cream dates and drink all kinds of exotic elixirs and nectars together. Grown-ups are in love, they'll make joint bank accounts together, go to movies together, and feed popcorn kernels to the rats and cockroaches here. And then one day, if you're lucky, your partner will take the kids away forever, you'll marry Steve, the guy in your accounting firm, works in the same cubicle as you, makes 6% more per year than you, and finally have a good night's sleep. So you got divorced? Nice. That's love, my scary friend. Speaking of which, we have a promotion on today. It's for Valentine's Day. 2 tickets for the price of 1. For couples who are in love. Hold on, I cannot handle this music. It's so bad. Oh. You can somehow convince someone to bring you here. You can. I don't know. Force him to pay you in, or like a parasite. Granted, take a real bath. Mission acquired. Oh god, that sores me. Okay, go do that. Away from here. Just, you see, with this moment. Please don't come back at all. Rude. Sure, you're rude. Oh no. It's the fan. Fun fair date. That's a nice phone. Is that a hotel phone? Oh no. Ah, tent, sweet tent. That's where I sleep. Oh my god. Find a well-functioning member society to latch on like a parasite, you have to leave your tent, you know. Great stuff. Let's go lay these eggs. Attitude. Bring out the main menu at any point using the S key. Okay. Okay, cool, thanks. Thanks, dog of wisdom. What's that? Let's go to the park. Why not? Let's see some cute doggos there, you know. Ah, the park. Could go a little around the nice spring grass. Unless you mind getting your feet discarded, so the range is stuck in your own. Oh, God. So what now? Let's not roll in there. Town, dial town. Let's get ran over. Everything and everyone. Not cool enough to be in downtown, dial town. So, what now? Summon a local hobo. Are we really that bad? Sure. I summon the. Yes! Yo! Hey, nice to meet you, friend. Your name's Hound. You need some? New? Ow, I'm the oldest thing alive. The dinosaur? Okay, kind of thinks it's like cheating and stuff. But yeah, I'm older than pretty much every dinosaur I met. Yeah, thing is, kind of like God and stuff. Create everything around you right now. Pour out the cosmos and the stars and. Yeah, kind of a big deal actually. Well, yeah, most things. But not everything? Well, yeah, you guys did some of the work, to be fair. I'm not gonna be mean. No, not quite. I never, like, leave a takeout box in the corner room and forget to bend the box. Always buy a new species that evolved from the remains of your chicken Thai curry from last month. Rolled my takeout box and I'm hungover, dude, gazing up upon the infinite possibility and disgust and awe. Yeah, it's nice to meet you. God, how much would that even cost? $1, maybe even $2? Do I look like I have $2 right now? Reality. Look at the happening around this room, or we call Earth right now. You honestly think I have a clue what's going on? One of you be gone for a day. Going so soon, eh? What's the rush? Oh, hey. One of those reptile fellows that made a few million or so years ago. Not judging, just saying. You guys are weird. Good luck conquering the human race and whatnot, though. You never see it coming. Ciao. Howdy-do, green partner. Name's Mikey. Just short for. Actually, scratch that. Mikey works just fine. I'm suspicious of you. Well, pleased to make your acquaintance, partner. It's nice. So what can I do for you on this fine spring afternoon? Aw, shucks, partner. I would, don't get me wrong. But, alas, I'm actually on my way to do a book signing. I'm lurking at Dialtown's newest best-selling writer. Well now, ain't that quinky-dink. All of my bestsellers happen to be about parasites of all kinds. We won't find a man who knows more about parasitums. Okay. And all Dialtown partner. Speaking of, let me know what I can do for you. Cause any longer and I'll be running tardy. So this guy. My current book is all about people parasites. Like what all me? Nah, people, you know. Flesh colored bipedal critters. from your old deck colors. Can't say I've ever seen it in green, though, Vardner. I suppose you want a copy of my latest book, would you? Pictures in it? Sure are, partner. It's one per chapter. There are words what I have to read. Yeah, I mean, it is a book. Well, shucks. Can't say I didn't try. Is that it then, partner? Give me a fact. You know, there's a whole world of screwed up critters out there. I love all of it. You know, there's a critter out there, a little isopod called the tongue louse that lives in the ocean, and oh boy. Crawls into a fish's mouth, rips off his fish's tongue, and becomes its new It's messed up. Pretty relatable, sounds like something I'd totally do. In fact, any time partner, I like Mike. It's kinda cool. Are you into me? Ow, no offense, but I think you might be upsetting to clock at. I get that a lot. Though, if you would happen to have to say a few tapeworms wiggling around and all that gut of yours, give me a call. You do. There might be some free isopod crab in it for ya. It's kinda edible. Yeah, look like you'd probably eat what I have in my bag. Call me later. Find out, partner. For now, is that all? Bye, Mikey. Scoot. On job. Oh. Why'd you wander in here, headaches? Phone trap of all places. I was just... Someone. Hold your horses, sweetie. Hold your horses. What's up? What are you holding hollering her for, hon? Where am I? Heaven. Oh wait, this place is far too drab for that. River Styx, perhaps? Oh, I get ya, because of where all the phone cases. Those ain't skulls, hon. They're just empty cases. I don't understand. Do you want to understand? Sure thing. Brief is the only way I speak. We're standing in the Dialtown Phone Store. Shop's near 100 years old now, set from up by my pa, God rest his soul. Shop initially sold old telephones, but with them being so common nowadays, well, we adapted to fit the current market. Not every purchase has to break the bank, you know. 100 pieces to sell, just as good as one complete phone, I find. Same thing goes for most aspects of life, I also find. There's nothing wrong with building yourself up bit by bit. Now, if you want to know about something specific, I'm sure I can oblige. Can you tell me about yourself? You want to know about me? Oh, well, I'm not all that interesting. Just been alive long enough to hear a few interesting notions, meet a few interesting people. I'm old. Your eyes ain't doing so hot. Sorry, I meant optical sensors or whatever they're called now. But I see, if you see with them, they're eyes. No matter if your head's a phone, typewriter, or what have you. Anyway, story ain't much to tell. Life was a story? I'm sure I'd be one of those bit characters, you know, the sort. Sitting around the same place all day, just waiting to be found. So I could share what I know about our funny little world. My father's probably would have been a better person to talk to, you know? Set up shop here a few shakes after a telegram went the way of the dodo. tragically, my pops had Colin Crown, his first telephone back in 42. Would have been Dialtown for a long time, I would lie. In a way, I feel to think that we're a part of history, even if only just... Oh, you know, I don't. The inventor, man who built the very first phone head. Philip became mayor of this our town, then per se of this our country. Yeah, America. Of course, this was all just before the worldwide dial-up, mind you. If it weren't for him, we'd still have our little fleshy heads and this world would be nothing like it is now. Most of the town did then, when I was a little girl. Couldn't avoid the fellow when he was campaigning for mayor, then president. Something about him was infectious. He knew just what he wanted. He had a vision, a dream. Fellows like him, don't matter what they do or where they go, they just attract that power. Sometimes that ain't the best thing for everyone though. That's the last I'll say on the subject. Yeah, when I was a little gal, the whole world had flush heads. No phones, typewriters. I mean, we had phones and typewriters around our homes and businesses, sure. Just not mounted to our shoulders. That would have been considered weird. Flesh heads too, all of them. No one had a mechanical head back then, human or otherwise. Neat. So, if you've got another question, I suppose I'll hear it. All sorts. Healthcare ain't exactly the most affordable and often enough. It's something small in the head that's acting up. Reverse the piece, shock, transmitter, etc, etc. So most people don't want to, or rather can't afford to go to a doc over every small malfunction part. So that's where I come in, or rather my shop and my parts do. Level head, and all it takes is a steady hand, an instruction course, plays the faulty part. Of course, to each their own. Still, I say people should see a doc for bigger issues if possible. Anyway, that's how things have been for most of my life, less recently, different parts still. Well, like I said, when y'all first came in, I saw phones. Don't you worry. Just piece by piece. Just gotta know how to adapt. Thinking of actually selling pieces. It's cosmetics. I see a lot of people, youngins, coming in here from time to time looking for whatever pieces I don't need. Slap them on their heads and bam, you got a hybrid head. Why? It's just them expressing themselves. Breaking down old societal rules, old concepts. See? The funny thing is, society seems to be changing with new people coming in and old people leaving. Back in my day, you were what others said you were and that was that. Things were cleaner, I guess you could say. You knew your role. But clean ain't perfect. Just meant folks were suffering out of earshot. Easy to take a beautiful photo when trash is shoved out of frame, ain't it? Now folks are speaking up for themselves and people missing the simple times. Just the times were never simple for the folks who are now speaking up for themselves. Change his name of Purdy. Out of curiosity, what do you think? I'm glad to hear that, friend. Oh, we found that your living is something you're not mighty ridiculous, even given we have technology to retain ourselves. Humans are just incomplete masterpieces, presumably truly can be considered as a stitch. An art ain't ever finished, it's abandoned. Don't ever give up on yourself. We can all change. Believe me, hon, I'm flattered. But, nah, I've got a store to manage, I'm afraid. Is it me? Nah, I mean, look, hon, I'm sure you'll find someone who isn't whatever it is that you are. Keep searching. God knows I got weird customers in here. If you know where to look for them, I know one will be bound to take you, so don't give up. I crave elderly romance. Yeah. Now you gonna buy something or what? I love Gabby. Gabby's my favorite. Alright, take care now, you hear? Summon Gabby. I like Gabby and Mikey. No, I think Mikey. Michael. I get my drift. See, that's some of an employee. Oh, well, hello there. Hey, ma'am, welcome. Whoa, pal. What? Really, those. 6? That's your next number. Half. As far as you know, I'm not about to be frank. Sick. I don't like the voice for this guy. Anyway, home slice. What can a humble popcorn dispenser do for you this fine spring afternoon? What is this place? Popcorn film dispensary, my good chum. I store customers at this counter by selling them overpriced snack food, then relay them a wondrous tale by beaming light straight at the silver screen. Magical movie room. Is this sorcery? Consider myself a sorcerer. Filth, perhaps. Magic conjurer of muck and grime, but this R4 isn't quite witchcraft, nor warlock, I'm afraid. No, the actual theming work comes from our dear old movie projector and busting my greatest love. Big Bertha. She's our pride and joy, been with the Simina since its founding day. Meaning, she's been here longer than I've been alive. She will likely outlive me too. Such is the way of the silver screen, yes. Oh, the usual kind. Which are, well, anything and everything that people will buy. I cannot make a voice for this guy. But I know he's like that. You know that. Hi, guy. Popcorn, hot dogs, ice cream, all overpriced and highly processed. I'm afraid not, friend. Horse jerky. Is it any good? It's chewy. Fascinating. We also serve fountain soda, but, well, I wouldn't recommend it. Well, my boss forbids me from opening a machine up or cleaning it out. That, and sometimes when it dispenses the soda, it screams. The soda screams? Like, a human scream comes from the machine. I think it's suffering. Okay. So, I just get your soda elsewhere and sneak in here. Now, did you want anything else? Well, we have a few movies showing, but I can't honestly recommend literally any of them. Well, one of them is about the sinking of the Titanic, but the ship is a giant telephone. I know, right? Beth Murphy is, well, our biopic on Milton Coolidge, The Venture of the Feather Duster. 3 of those 4 hours are compromised slowly, then slowly dancing in a dark room, both on grainy black and white footage while the actor weeps inconsolably. I know. But hey, I'm sure the entire medium film isn't like doomed forever or anything. Sorry, did you want anything else? Whoa, hey now, look. I'm really digging the injury worse. No, really? You can scan whatever's going on with those few wounds and stitches? That's inspired. Only thing is, I'm not really into typewriters. Wow, because I'm a typewriter? Okay. Sorry, sis. Don't call me sis. Don't. Have a nice day. But hey, if you want to buy some buttered popcorn with a consistency of cardboard of a richly gouged price, I believe I could be of assistance. No, I am leaving you. Stellar! See you around, ma'am. Get out of my life. Get out of me. Whoa. Get out of my face. Let's go. Bank. Let's rob a bank. Bank, really? Yes. Why the bank? This is destiny. So if you're correct. Right, and if the bank is full of couples making joint bank accounts together, you're not gonna know it's funny if I'm gonna make them particularly zero, since everyone making a joint account would be by definition very much already taken. You know what? I trust Jerry. What would you like to do? Ring for a teller. Oh, Jesus. What are you? Oh, it's a Karen. I didn't even read that. You're green. Yes. Hello, nice to meet you. Yeah, apologies if this comes off as rude, but were you born like that? Karen, I'm gonna slap you. Okay, sorry. Probably was a weird question to ask you. But were you? Freddy's eggs. Right, yes. Okay, thank you for clearing that up. Wow, were you having to make a transaction, ma'am, or? Look. Ma'am, I often fail to take sarcasm, but come on, surely that's a jest. Yeah, that was a joke. Fantastic. That is all then? So your head. Yeah, it's a printer. I know that's really typical, but believe me, ma'am, I get this every day. I don't have anyone working for me. I'm an employee. How does it work? With ink. You have seen a printer before, right? Well, I wouldn't know truly because I've had a printer before that for as long as I remember, so I have no point of comparison. That's all I know, you know? Still, people get uppity about how I express myself, and why is that? Well, most typewriters like yourself print out pages with words on them. I produce pictures. People don't really like that. listening. She said that I can't paint birds, and that's the issue. So to my sponsors, if you're going to ask questions. Well, if I speak literally, the idioms go over my head. Yes, I am aware that's an idiom. I get that one now because phone lord people jump straight to idioms to explain not getting idioms. Because I'm the one not getting how basic things work apparently. I'm sorry, yeah. I diverted the topic. Is there anything else I can help you with then? Taken by what exactly? What is this? What are you asking? Can I help you? Firstly, never call me that again, thanks. Secondly, what? Asking me out on a date. I don't understand. I knew that. It's really 14th already. So what, you're asking me out on a Valentine's Day on some kind of date? I mean, yeah. Well, I mean, yeah, I could let you take me out on Valentine's Day, sure. But why are you asking me of all people? Oh boy, that makes me feel wanted. Well, say what you meant. Beating you around the bush. Your green skin half doesn't even get me started on whatever your head is cracked out of. Hal, have you seen the kind of customers I get on a daily basis? The last few dudes before you came in and Shiba Inu. Oh well. And a woman who had a... Oh. Guess which one? You're weird, but you're not day-ruining weird. Well, I'm behind glass, so I can't really smell you. You do look like you smell weird, though. See, the thing is, Dialtown's a weird place. Hell, the world is a weird place. The way I see it, since everyone's weird, maybe no one is. Not too far from this goofball, some weirdos who simply wind up in the wrong place at the wrong time, you know? So no, I don't see you as a monster. Just a cryptid who's actually kind of talked me into this somehow. Beat your chest. I'm not really the one thing that allows me to put food on the table. Well, look, this is a niche that needs to be filled. My enjoyment is completely irrelevant. I don't know. Come on, Karen. Okay, fine, you're right. Yeah, later, I guess. I'm really pretty much anywhere else, if I'm being honest. It's kind of really moist and loud. Like my ex's apartment. It's fun! Quiet. Drying sanitary places can be too... be fun too, you know. Okay. Whatever it is then, I guess. Alright then. Away we go! Where we don't go. Shift doesn't end for another couple of hours. Shift ends at 6 p.m. It's like it's taking a good 30 minutes to reach the fun fair. Give or take, not counting traffic, just getting hit by bus or like kidnapped. say 6:30 for the sake of simplicity. Oh? No, because my boss saw me letting you order here for that length of time when I get sacked. So, you can wait for me wherever you want. Just not here. That is quite the question. Should you wait? Where should we wait? Let's just go. Yes. To the fun fair. Ticket Jerry. God, no way. Where's my damn can repellent? Please, I implore you, vile demon, tired and near death. Surely there's another tired tertiary sector worker somewhere in this hornet's nest of a town that you can bother even half as early as you have me. Jerry, we have a special. Let me in or else you will learn the true meaning of Christmas. Well, bones never squeaked before yesterday. That and I had an x-ray done recently and I can now say for a fact there's a good bit of dust inside me. Still turning 30, Jerry. Are you just tending to be witty or are you somehow aware that I've celebrated my 30th birthday recently? That depends. And the 30th birthday cake I found earlier today, yours? Why were you foraging through the contents of the fairground dumpster? So even these single fairgoers who are out there extra get one free ticket. Also, you know, for good. I see. Please don't use the cake to extract DNA from family members to produce imperfect clones of them in the vain hope that the act will scar me enough to just let you go into the fun tour without further resistance. Wow, that sounds like a novel idea. It's a pity that my IQ is greater than 3, but less than 17, though. Sponge Jerry, really? Maybe live a little. I'll have you know that my wife baked the cake. Your wife is a treacherous wretch. She will simply have to perish in the revolution. No, you don't. Are you seriously tempted to intimidate me with final threats now? Look, ma'am, this is simple. Find someone to take you here, and voila, I can display a festive loophole to gain entry. It's out of my hands. My boss has been legally registered as a houseplant and is watering me down to tax forms as a work expense. I'm gonna be a lowering rung here. I do have someone to take. Well, then, mostly just wanted to expel you since you waited this late into conversation to tell me that. Okay, so, where's your date then? Yes. Should you wish to take me? Nope, not any. So your date better be here sharpish. It's barely past noon, what are you doing here? Go, shoo! If I could move the ticket booth in its entirety, ma'am, then why'd you stop me simply running through the gaping ticket booth size hole that you've left in your primary's defenses? Huh. Do you mind if I take that idea down for the next time I see my boss? I hate being shot at. Look. Go home, get some rest, maybe freshen up for your date. Rather, in what I imagine to be a difficult case for you, come back even stickier than you are now. Funfair will still be here when you get back. I will still be here when you get back. And Heck, maybe your date will be too. Come on, ma'am. It's Valentine's Day for me too. Surely I deserve a break as well. Thank phone god. I love it. Let's get freshened up. Home sweet home. Home sweet, well, okay, maybe not as such. Sweet in the same way that the closing rabbit that soaked in vinegar would be, I guess. So not at all. Precisely, yes. That and, you know, it smells like pee in here. Man, yeah, man, right on. Please stop that. Sure, right on, man, yeah, man. Well, at least you get to be alone in your own thoughts, right? You okay, bud? Nice thoughts. You really do need constant stimulation at all times, don't you? Oh. See much difference? Those individuals hardly count as human, though. And I do. Checkmate. Ooh. I was kidding. Hey, look, a distraction. What is that? A distraction? You don't mean a... That's a cockroach? That's a fridge with legs. That's a fridge. Not usually, no. No, please don't eat it. I'm not gonna- oh, no. Not even you would. Despicable. I have no regrets. I have numerous regrets. Well, I don't. Life has been a shell of an existence. Lay off, man. I live in a tent. An empire of dirt. Dirt's fine, man. Grass grows from it and... Worms are neat too. You just ate a cockroach. Didn't even season it. I think I have salt. What am I, a Roman, like, seconds after receiving their... How do you not know what grapple's primary function is, yet have enough trivia knowledge to know how the Roman Empire pay their soldiers? How long have you been around? God, how long have I been around? Saying that. Oh, nectar. I'm calling it a time to get splooged. Stop talking. I beseech you. Also, should you stay sober for your date? After all, I hardly want to chug too much of that. Let's see, you ride the tablet if you can. What nerves? First comments can be. Any former use. And their muscles might bend. Oh. Do it. Don't do that. Don't make Jerry a category. Don't make Jerry a thing. Aside from, like, performing function in society, he's a wife and several very ill to care for. He has a house somewhere. Maybe they have to keep his lawns in shape. I like ticks and junk. So it's society, not ecosystem. I'm following my round instead. I would, except Jerry is too well adjusted to here. Maybe nectar. Don't match. Ugh, you're gonna regret this. What is that? Caramel. Jeremio. It's the me. You are a my disgrace. What the? I've been here for an hour. I told you exactly when I'd be here. Give or take traffic times. Traffic isn't even that bad tonight. What on earth took you so long? Sorry, so pardon my ignorant. I'm very important, yes, and you are. Okay, see, you should have been honest to just take my advice and left as soon as I advise you to again. She's clearly on her mind and I'm following God knows what. I smell like synthetic raspberry and told her nightmares. Why'd you look so sticky? Sorry, I'm, you know, sometimes late on how doing. Sometimes really is sometimes. Yep, those were all words, alright. More what she thinks she's saying. She really still want to do this, Karen? I mean, she does look pretty sticky. I don't know. I can tell if I'm more upset that she handled on a mystery nectar, or that she forced me to wait at the gate for hours while she holds in her habits. Inge. Karen. A new specimen. More to advance. Down to the bare essentials. Aaron, run. I'll distract her with fast hand motions and plenty of vocal noises while you skedaddle. No, this is awful, but... Oh, this is honestly the last outcome I predicted would have happened. Angry as I am, I kinda wanna see what will happen next. Karen, you're not. Surely $2 is worth the price of admission. To Funfair and for a front row seat for whatever kind of caper this could possibly be. Do you have money? See, I heard a lot of MTS in there. Doesn't want to indicate no answer. Karen, she's just using you for a free ticket. You know, on account of the whole 2-for-1 ticket deal we got going on tonight. Really? So the whole only shred of affection that I've shown in the last 5 years is just great stuff. Just wants you to pay her in like a printer clutching parasite. So she can lay her eggs in a damn ditch deep within the Funfair's untamed grounds. Oh, I get it. I thought you were actually serious when we were there. No, Karen, I really mean it. She really is going to. I may have a bit of a reputation for not detecting the turtle again, but come on, Jerry. Even if I fold to believe that lays eggs. Karen, I really mean it. She's akin to Sasquatch. An oily, moist, egg-laying Sasquatch. 2 tickets for me and my date, please, Jerry. It's a wild story, I know, but... Why do I even care? Just out of my hands now. Yes! You two go, I guess. Enjoy the... Yeah. We go in, yes. Okay, egg-laying talk aside, you are definitely under the influence or something. Oh my god. Alright, here we are. Hope for your sake, you're at least partly sobering up. Otherwise, this won't be much of a talkative night. Egg. Sobriety. Is that a yes? Or a mere acknowledgement of the concept of sobriety? I'm getting there, Carbo. I'm getting there. That was almost my name, so that's reassuring. You go on a ride or two. Get the last bit of nectar from me, old gut. Well, alright. What did you have in mind? How about a crab claw looking thing that screams deafening metal and... That was kind of terrifying. Too bad I don't do loud. Why does me know at the funfair of all places? Funfair was your. Surely you can think of something at least somewhat quieter than El Grabo. Oh, the coast over there. A funeral planner, I think it's called. Not a chance. Why not? You know why it's called the funeral planner, don't you? Not as such, no. Okay, that filled in some gaps, yeah. Alright, so you want something that isn't flashy, loud, or dangerous? Ideally, yes. Jeez, that really whittles down her selection, doesn't it? Well, how about the carousel? What is that? I don't speak Italian. It's... In terms you understand horse wheel? Oh, the horsey wheel! Why didn't you just say that? Yes, the horsey wheel. Man, I haven't seen one of those babies in a long time. You like horses then? I kinda do, yeah. Why, do you? Alright, I guess. Right. Right. Don't take this the wrong way, but you are awful at dating. Thanks. I agree. I am awful at dating. Thanks. Oh, that is... Say, what's this? What do you mean? Why are their heads like that? Oh. Well, must be an antique. I don't understand. Why doesn't this horsey have an engine for a head? How else can I properly gauge the beast's horsepower? Like I said, it's clearly an antique. Carousel must have been produced before the worldwide dial-up. Just wasn't us who had that done to us, you know, animals too. Really? Yes, we known this. Originally, mechanical and organic and tiles were distinct. The whole world was altered? Surely not everyone must have been manually changed. Surely someone must have been missed, right? Don't tell me this is another one of your clown theories again. Okay, never mind. Let's get on the horsey wheel. Oh yes. Fun. This is nice. You know, I really didn't think anything particularly fruitful would come from tonight, but... I think I feel... What? Hello, Karen. Oh my god. I am green. Oh no, my gut. Shooketh mine out. Pardon? It's egg time. I'm sorry, what? It's been real. I must now flee to a nearby ditch. Wait. Time to lay some eggs. Here. Something will do. Do you really think abandoning Karen like that was fair? Is nothing secret anymore? Shut! For no one. Not for me. Not even the horse wheel. Alright, fine. And for no one. Oh. Oh, there you are. Your younglings. Oh. Pride. They're right. Not much to owie. I haven't hatched yet. Yes, you are. Speak as pre-hatchling. Oh wait, speaking of hatchlings, would you a little explode? Oh god. Yeah, bury them. There we go, now I can. Oh, there you are. Oh, hey, Karen. You're about ditching you, I had to, get give birth. Seriously? Can you believe that you... The nest, Karen. Dig for the eggs, they lie beneath the topsoil. Let me get this straight. You want me to dig into the cold, hard earth with my bare hands? Let's check whether or not they've laid eggs while it's on our date. Yeah, but you would just run off me like this during an intimate moment, no less. What else should I expect? I'm just so feral. You're not asking me at the worst possible time. But you've piqued my curiosity, so reveal what you want, knowing that I'm mostly sorry, no. Oh, no. Never get my car seat dry again after you touched it. Look like you created sticky spots of sand just by sitting down. Right. Yeah, well, I'm off. It's just dreadful. Thank you. See you again soon. No! I think that went great. Yeah, that went great. That was amazing. I really liked it. It was funny. Yeah. That's fun. And I am gonna sleep now. Because it is 6:58 a.m. So,